ladies and gentlemen, yes, a bye week has occurred for Oklahoma, so they've had lots of time to get ready for their upcoming Saturday game. Yes, it is time for the weekly matchup show, as the Sooners will enter their Saturday night contest on Fox Sports Net, 6 o'clock kickoff against Iowa State, as a 22-point favorite. We're going to talk a little bit more about this matchup in a second. There's really not a whole lot of detail to get into between the Cyclones and the Sooners. It's not really a complicated game plan. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. But first, we have to talk about the BCS, the Bowl Championship Series, because its first official standings will be released this Sunday. Of course, the top two teams in the BCS at the end of the year will play for the national championship, which this year is in Glendale, Arizona. According to ESPN, this is their mock ESPN standings. If the BCS were to have come out yesterday, it would have looked something like this. Ohio State at number 5. Interesting, because Ohio State is ranked number 1 in both the AP and the coaches' polls. Oklahoma, number 4. Oklahoma, by the way, is 6th in both major polls. TCU at 3. Oregon at number 2. And number 1, according to this mock BCS that ESPN did yesterday, which uses the same formula as a real BCS, Boise State would be number 1. Do I think that's going to last? No. And the biggest reason is because as the year progresses, Boise State's computer ranking is going to drop. Because right now, what this mock BCS did was they've looked at who Boise State has played already. They played Virginia Tech, and they've played Oregon State. They're not taking into account the future opponents that Boise will have later in October and in November. The Western Athletic Conference, other than Nevada, will be nothing but weaklings for Boise State on their schedule, and it will drive Boise State's computer ranking down, which means that their overall BCS ranking is going to go down. They'll still be a factor, but they're not going to stay number one, and the computer ranking will be the reason why. So just to throw that out there, Oklahoma being at number 4, you might think, why so high? Remember who they've played so far, Air Force and Florida State. Both teams haven't lost since Oklahoma beat them, and both teams are ranked in the USA Today top 25. By the way, the BCS uses the Harris poll and the USA Today coaches poll. They don't use the Associated Press poll, just so you know. So obviously for Oklahoma, it would really help if Florida State, who just blitzed Miami the other night in Miami, if they and Air Force can continue to win, and if Cincinnati, who plays in a weak Big East conference, can do the same as well. That will only help Oklahoma's computer ranking. So the BCS, two-thirds of it is human, one-third of it's computer, and that's a big reason why Oklahoma is being aided by the BCS. But the first official standings will come out on Sunday. The BCS, this mock BCS I gave you, by the way, does not take this upcoming Saturday's games into consideration. So if you have some upsets this Saturday, kind of like what we had last Saturday, then the rankings are going to be altered. Now, let's talk a little bit about the Iowa State Cyclones, a team that last year went to a bowl game. Surprised a lot of people. Paul Rhodes did one heck of a job with the Cyclones. They finished at 7-6, not only got to a bowl game, but won their bowl game over Minnesota. This season for Iowa State to get to a bowl game, it's going to be pretty tough. Right now they're at 3-3. They have losses to Iowa, to Kansas State, and this past Saturday giving up 68 points to Utah. Utah's a pretty good team, but still I thought Iowa State would have put up a better fight than losing 68-27. Utah putting up nearly 600 yards of total offense. That's a big problem right now for the Cyclones, is the fact that their defense is bad, not just in one facet, but running and passing defense. It's terrible. They're dead last right now in the Big 12 in total D. So for Iowa State to even think about an upset in Norman, it's got to start first on the defensive side, being able to force turnovers. Good luck on that, because Oklahoma, number one in the country right now in turnover margin. They've been spectacular in that department. For the Cyclones, when they get the ball, it's going to be largely a running committee. Chantrell Johnson as well as Alexander Robinson, two quality backs for Iowa State, expect the Cyclones to heavily rely upon the run. Austin Arnaud is a pretty good quarterback for Iowa State. He's a veteran. Problem is, Iowa State really doesn't have what you would call a deep a wide receiver deep threat, a game breaker, in other words. They'll throw short passes, high percentage passes. And for Arnaud last week against Utah, it was a pretty bad game. I believe he went like 13 of 32 throwing the ball. Had more incompletions than completions. That much I do know. Iowa State, there is no question about it. They're going to have to be able to throw successfully against Oklahoma. Otherwise, this thing will be over, and it'll be over, maybe over by halftime. That is, if they play the way this Saturday that they did last Saturday against the Utes. And that game, by the way, was in Ames, Iowa. And believe it or not, Iowa State actually led 14-10 in that game at the end of the first quarter, only to see Utah score 31 points in the second. So did Iowa State have a pretty bad game? Well, duh, of course. Now, Oklahoma, no doubt about it, when they get the ball, and this is going to be one of my four keys to this game. Key number one, naturally, run like the wind blows. A game where DeMarco Murray will be featured quite a bit, as well as Moses Madu. By the way, Roy Finch, who's been hobbled by injury this season, he could be available for Oklahoma. Boy, wouldn't that be nice to have another quality running back for the Sooners. I would not be surprised if this is one of those games for Oklahoma where you don't see Landry throw near as much, just because Iowa State has shown vulnerability against the run. 102nd in the country out of 120 teams in rush defense. Last time I checked, that was awful. So do expect the Oklahoma Sooners to run and run a bunch. Iowa State, again, has been pathetic in that department. Number two, if you're Oklahoma, naturally contain the run, because Iowa State, this is going to be their bread and butter, using both Johnson and Robinson quite a bit. And also remember, Austin Arnaud is a good athlete as well, and sometimes athletic quarterbacks give Oklahoma fits. So Oklahoma will have to have their homework completed, not only containing the running backs for Iowa State, but also being able to handle Arnaud, because he is multidimensional. Number three, we mentioned earlier that the turnovers, Oklahoma has been spectacular in this area, but also Iowa State, they're in the top 20 in the country in turnover margin. These are two teams that generally don't make a lot of mistakes as far as handling the football. So for Oklahoma, don't give up anything cheap. The one way that you can make a ball game like Iowa State interesting, which it shouldn't be interesting, is by fumbling the ball, by Landry Jones making mistakes with interceptions. So just take care of business and you'll be fine. And then number four, three the hard way. We're talking about third down conversions. Big reason why Iowa State lost last week was because they didn't do much with the football. 0 for 13 on third down conversions. So if Iowa State has any shot at making this a ball game in the second half, then third down conversions have to be much better than 0 for 13. And conversely for Oklahoma, take care of the third down situations as well. That means don't pin yourself in third and long situations. My final thought on this game, unless Oklahoma just plays like pure junk, and unless Iowa State plays like an Iowa State team that we haven't seen all season, and I know that they beat Texas Tech, I understand that, but I'm not very high on Tech right now. Unless we see a different Iowa State team, this baby should belong to Oklahoma. I'm going to go 45-17. Oklahoma should score a lot of points. They should get a lot of time for their backups to play in this game. This one, I look for Oklahoma to cover that 22-point spread, winning this game by 28. That's going to be my forecast. For Iowa State, if they hope to get to another bowl game, simply put, they've got to win three of their last six games. And to do that, they're going to have to beat somebody that they're not expected to beat. Because after this game, it doesn't get easier for the Cyclones playing at Texas. And they still have games at home against Nebraska, at home against Missouri to close things out. And then, of course, they have to play Colorado and Kansas. Colorado and Kansas, they'll have a good shot at beating, but Mizzou, Nebraska, the Longhorns, the Sooners, they're underdogs against, and they might be big underdogs against all four of those teams. So more than likely, Iowa State's going to go 5-7 and just miss out on the bowl game. Final score again, I've got Oklahoma winning this one 45-17.